Hello, good morning. Today's talk is on Kalidasa's Shakuntala or The Lost Ring, a well-known play. This is a topic for our discussion today as far as the communication skill in English is concerned. Before talking about the central idea of the play, let me tell you something about the origin, the birth and origin of Shakuntala. We are told that once upon a time, the great sage called Vishwamitra was meditating, penancing, performing his yogic activities in order to gain the power of the whole world, that is to say, heaven and earth. If he could complete his meditation, it was possible for him to become the ruler of the whole world. And when king of heaven called Indra came to know about his activities, he was shocked, he was threatened by this, and therefore he wanted to do something in order to stop his meditation. So he planned, he asked Apsara or Menaka, one of the most beautiful women in the heaven, to go to the earth and distract the attention of Vishwamitra. Accordingly, she descended on the earth and she went to the place where he was meditating. She started performing her beautiful, charismatic and most alluring dance and her melodious songs that had attracted the attention of Vishwamitra. Vishwamitra was attracted towards her and he fell in love with her at the very first sight. Both of them got married. They spent several days together. In the passage of time, she gave birth to a female child and they named this female child as Shakuntala. After fulfilling her task, after completing her task, she went back to the heaven, leaving the child behind. At the very same time, sage Vishwamitra was on his forest retreat, and before leaving, he handed over the child in the hands of Kanva. As far as Kanva is concerned, you know that Kanva was another rishi. He was another sage and he was the head of the hermitage. By handing over the female child in the hands of so-called Kanva, he went back to the forest. Now under the affectionate and loving patronage of Kanva, she was born and brought up. She was brought up, of course, and she has attained her full beauty, prime beauty, and now she has become quite beautiful. At this point of time, we are told that the king of Hastinapur called Dushyanta has come there. He was chasing, he was running after the deer in the forest. And now Kanva came across to him. Now Kanva requested Dushyanta not to kill the deer because he has taken the responsibility of protecting all the animals of the forest. Dushyanta, without any kind of hesitation at the back of his mind, also accepted the request and stopped chasing the deer. At this point of time, we are told that all of a sudden he happened to look at a particular site. And the site was, of course, three maidens, most beautiful maidens in the hermitage. They were watering the plants in the garden, and one of the maidens was, of course, Shakuntala. And Shakuntala attracted his attention a lot. At the very first sight of the beauty of Shakuntala, he fell in love with her. And both of them got married, both of them spent one night together. The next morning, he had to leave the forest, leave the hermitage, and to attend his court duties. So, before departing from her, he had given her most precious ring from his own finger and asked her not to lose the ring at any cost. And then he went off. In the passage of time, what happened was that she was concerned about Dushyanta, more and more about Dushyanta, and One day, while she was thinking about him, she had completely engrossed in him. And at this point of time, there was another sage called Durvasa. He's known for his quick anger, had come there, and he begged food for her. She did not pay attention towards him, so Durvasa became so angry and he cursed her. And in that curse, he said that the man about whom she was thinking will forget her. And then he went off. After that, what happened was that in the passage of time, we are told that there were certain physical changes which were noticeable in her. And when the inquiry was made, she revealed the truth that she was pregnant from King Dushyanta. Then her adopted father Kanva made a preparation for her to send her to her husband Dushyanta in the palace of Hastinapur. She was traveling by the boat. While she was traveling by the boat, due to the cold breeze of the wind, she fell asleep and the ring from her finger fell into the water of the river. She did not realize it. She did not notice it. She was unconscious. She was unaware of it. But when she went to the palace gate, she told the people at the palace that she was the wife of Dushyanta and she wanted to see him. When she was presented before the king failed to recognize her. Now, she said that the king had given her a ring, and when she tried to take out the ring from her finger, she realized that there was no ring, and therefore she was unable to produce the ring. So she was dejected, she was rejected, so she went up, went into the jungle. Here the king was very busy in dealing with his court activities, and he had to deal with number of enemies. He had defeated number of enemies. And after that, what happened was that at this point of time, a fisherman from Hastinapur came to see the king and presented that particular ring to the king. He said that while fishing, he caught one of the fish, and in the stomach or in the belly of that particular fish, he got this particular ring which is having a royal mark on it. And he has bought that particular ring to the king, but now it was too late for the king. Now the king has to go to the after settling all the disputes in his kingdom, he was supposed to pay his visit to the heaven. So he was supposed to go on his heavenly tour, and he went into the heaven. He had to fight with the demons in the heaven along with the warriors in the heaven. He was successful in combating the demons in heaven. He had to spend several years over there. After fulfilling his task, he was on his way back to his palace. But while coming back to palace, he asked a charioteer called Mitali to take his chariot to the hermitage of Maricha, because he wanted to pay homage to the hermitage. Accordingly, the chariot was taken to the hermitage of Mirachi, and Mitali, who was his charioteer, left him alone, and where he felt heavenly presence, heavenly grace, peace and tranquility of that particular hermitage. He became so happy and delighted to have that kind of perception. And at the same time, he heard something. In order to see what was happening at that particular direction, when he turned, he saw a small boy who was trying to open the mouth of the cub and trying to count the teeth of that cub. He was marveled at it, and so he went towards that particular boy, pampered the boy, asked the boy, and when the ascetics of the hermitage, they were surprised to see that he was feeling comfortable with a stranger. He means that particular boy. When inquiry was made, it was revealed that the boy was none else but his own son, and his wife called Shakuntala was staying in the same hermitage. So she was brought before him. She was presented to him. They reunited. He took both of them to his palace, and that's how the story comes to an end. It has a happy ending, and this is a very interesting story to understand. Thank you very much.